43, I had a question coming out of chapter 12, number 73. And here we were given a PDF and we were asked to find this missing probability. I scratched it out for right now. And then could you find the expected value? So in terms of PDFs, typically when we write PDFs, we only write the two columns, right? We don't usually have this one. You can have it there if you want. But we usually write a column or a row with a sample space, right, listing all possible values of our variables. And then we have the probabilities over here, either in the second column or the bottom row. And one of the big properties of this is that these four numbers here, they have to total out to one. So for right now, I'm just going to call this one X. And we're going to see that 0.3 plus 0.2 plus X plus 0.4, that has to total out to one, because that probability column or row, it always totals out to one, right? If you've covered every option in your sample space, the probabilities have to total out to 100%, because something has to happen when you run an experiment. So if I simplify this a little bit, if I take the like terms here of 0.3, 0.2, and 0.4, that's 0.9. So I get X plus 0.9 has to equal 0.1. Oops, not, that's a lie. It has to equal one. And then when you subtract it, you get X equaling 0.1. And if I erase what I have here, you'll see that I have 0.1 living there. All right, and then the next question, well, that was part A. So we found the probability that X was equal to 2. Then we were asked in part B for the expected value. And expected value, it's another vocab term that means mean, right? And we've learned also we can use the word average. So now we have three vocab terms that mean the same thing. And if you want to use the formula, you take these little products. You do the value of the variable times its probability, right? So you see me doing 0 times 0.3, 1 times 0.2, 2 times 0.1, 3 times 0.4. And then you total all of those out and you could get to 1.6. And that's fun. I genuinely do think it's fun. But the quicker way is just to put your sample space, typically in L1, the probabilities in L2, and then run one varsats L1 comma L2 and read X bar. And there's your mean. All right. Now, we weren't given units in this problem, so I can't write anything in terms of units, but I do know the expected value is 1.6. All right. Thanks so much. Bye.